ओके टुडे चैप्टर इज श्रद्धा त्रय विभाग योगा द डिविजन ऑफ फेथ ओके अमज्ञान तिमिरंधस्य ज्ञानंजन शालकाय चक्षुरुन्मोहितं येन तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः नमः विष्णु पादाय कृष्ण प्रस्थाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्ति वेदांत स्वामिनिति नामिने नमस्ते सारस्वते देवे गौरवाणी प्रसारिणी निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाश्चात्य देश तारिणी जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्त वृंद हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे सो वेलकम श्रद्धा त्रय विभाग योगा डिविजन्स ऑफ फेथ नाउ ऋतिक सूर्या प्लीज अनम्यूट हरे कृष्णा सो इन दिस चैप्टर अर्जुन इज आस्किंग फ्यू क्वेश्चंस टू कृष्णा एंड कृष्णा विल गिव द आंसर्स सो व्हाट आर द क्वेश्चंस वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर आवर लाइफ व्हाट एवर वी आर डूइंग इन डे टू डे एक्टिविटीज सेम क्वेश्चंस अर्जुन इज आस्किंग टू कृष्णा अनम्यूट ऋषिक सूर्या
Yes, I think Dhriti can do.
Yes.
Yes, Prabhuji. Hare Krishna, Prabhuji.
Yes, yes. Read this translation.
Arjuna inquired, O Krishna, what is the situation of those who do not follow the principles of scripture but worship according to their own imagination? They are they in goodness, in passion, or in ignorance?
Yes. So Arjuna is asking, and there are many people in this world who worship, who have the faith little bit, but they do not follow the scripture. What happened normally nowadays, people don't read the scripture. They're telling they don't have time to read. So those type of people, definitely they cannot follow the scripture because they are not reading. So Arjuna is asking, because in Kali Yuga, usually people will be like this. They will have little faith, they will do worship, but they don't follow the scripture. So Arjuna is asking, what about this condition? Whether these people are in mode of goodness, passion, or ignorance. Okay, next what Krishna will tell, we'll see. Who will read the sloka? Ahan. Unmute Ahan.
Ahan, yeah, I'll do. Ahan, is it Ahan Mallikarjun?
I think.
Prabhuji, yeah. I am doing translation.
Okay, then sloka, Anibad, you can read the sloka.
Prabhuji, but can I?
You, what is your
Actually,
name?
Actually, my name.
What is your name?
My name is Rishik Surya.
Okay, you can read the translation. Sloka.
Okay. Yajante Satvika Devan Yaksha Raksha Rakshamsi Rajasa Pretan Bhuta Ganmas Ganams Chanye Yajante tamasa jana.
Okay. Ahan, you can read the translation. Hare Krishna, Ahan. Hare Krishna, Ahan. You are muted. Don't mute.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji.
Yes, yes, great.
Men in the mode of goodness worship the demigods. Those in the mode of passion worship the demons. And those in the mode of ignorance worship ghosts and spirits.
Yes. So Krishna is telling there are three types of people, like we have already discussed about the three modes of material nature, goodness, passion and ignorance, sattvic, rajasic and tamasic. So similarly, there are three types of people that worship three type of things, like a person in goodness usually worship demigods. Okay, then person in passion, they worship usually demons or the demoniac people. Some people worship different person also, the powerful person they worship. So those powerful persons are usually demoniac in nature. And a person in ignorance, they usually worship ghost and spirit. Okay. Now you can see here the picture, these are the demigods. So this, he is in the mode of goodness or sattvic. That's why they are worshipping different demigods. Lord Shiva, Brahma, Devi. And this is, you see, he's like demon. He's a little powerful person and the people will be worshipping him. Nowadays in this world, something happening like this. So this is a demoniac person. So usually the person with passion, they worship this type of people. Now in ignorance, they will go at night to some forest, they will do worship of ghosts and spirits. Okay. So which guna is above three modes? It is Suddha Sattva Guna. So even the mode of goodness, they worship Devi Devata. But when you worship Krishna, it is not in the mode of goodness. It is above the mode of goodness. That is called pure goodness or Suddha Sattva Guna. That is not in the material mode. That is spiritual mode. Yesterday we have discussed. Okay. Pure goodness or Suddha Sattva Guna. So Krishna wants us not to be in goodness, passion or ignorance. He wants us to come to the level of pure goodness. That is Suddha Sattva Guna. That is spiritual platform. Then only we can reach the Golok. Otherwise, either we'll go to heaven or we'll go to hell or in the earth only. So here you can see, worship. If you worship Krishna, you'll go to Vaikuntha or Krishna Lok. That is Golok. So this is in the spiritual world. Now you worship the demigods, you'll go to the heaven. If you worship the demons, you'll go to hell. If you worship the ghost and spirit, you'll go to ghostly planet. So how you'll work, how you'll worship, similarly you'll get the result. Okay?
Excuse me, Prabhuji.
Yes, this is not good. Yes.
Prabhuji, Aditi has joined. Can you make a co-host?
Aditi left, in between.
Yes, he got disconnected.
Raise your hand. Hare Krishna.
Yes, he has raised.
Where is Aditi? Oh, Aditi. Yes. Okay. So now this is you are what you eat. Means yesterday we have discussed the type of food we eat, our mentality will be like that. Suppose we'll eat the sattvic ahar, we'll act like a sattvic person, our character will be sattvic. We'll eat the tamasic food, our character or activities will be tamasic. We cannot take tamasic food and activity will be sattvic, it is not possible. So that's why food is very important. We have to be very careful while taking the food. Who will read this? Samriddhi, please unmute Samriddhi.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji.
Yes, read.
Foods dear to those in mode of goodness increase the duration of life. So through one assistance and gives strength, health, happiness, and satisfaction. Such food are juicy, fatty, wholesome, and pleasing to the heart.
Yes. So food of goodness means this is always good for our health. So what are those food? Today we are taking many ignorant food, processed food. These are not good food. So what are the food of goodness? Usually the food juicy, we can take the fruit juice, fatty, wholesome fruits. Nowadays many processed foods are there. So instead of processed food, we have to take the wholesome fruit, foods and pleasing to the heart. So this type of food will increase the life, purify one's existence, give strength, health, happiness. So if you want strength, health, happiness, you have to take the food of goodness. Okay, you can see here. Prasadam, very nicely arranged. See, beautifully arranged. So if you take all this thing, your life will increase. You'll be disease free. Okay. Now unmute Kamlesh. So okay, this I am reading. Next Kamlesh will read. So food we consume is broken into three components. Now, grossest ingredient usually after digestion go to stool. Middling ingredient absorb into flesh. Okay, and the third constituent is subtlest ingredient. It usually absorbed into mind, go to consciousness. So this is how food has been distributed in our body. So here you can see the animal killing is seen. Don't make your body a graveyard. Because graveyard, what happens here? Dead body of the animal kept in the graveyard. So when you take the animal or animal flesh, so what happens? Usually you are taking the dead animal. So our body become like a graveyard. Okay, so that's why don't take the non-vegetarian food. This is related to your food habit. So how you will take the food? Similarly, you'll get the problem in your life. So we'll see what happens in actually when you take the food of passion and ignorance. Yes, Kamlesh, Kamlesh.
Devi.
Yes, Prabhuji. Kamlesh. Yes, you can unmute Kamlesh. Hare Krishna.
Yes, Prabhuji.
Yes.
Preparing food for Krishna. Cooking with good consciousness, offering to Krishna with love and devotion, correct mood for offering, honoring Krishna Prasad, and results of taking Krishna Prasad.
Yes. So this actually, this is in the mode of goodness. Not even goodness, it is mode of pure goodness. Okay. So spiritual mode and material mode, when you are preparing prasadam, it will be material mode goodness. But when you are preparing Krishna Prasadam, it will be pure goodness. So, offering to Krishna with love and devotion, correct the mood for offering, correct mood for offering, honoring Krishna Prasadam. Honoring means taking, result of taking Krishna. So, when you take the Krishna Prasad, this will purify our body. Body, mind and soul, everybody will be peaceful. Everything will be peaceful. That's why we should always take Krishna Prasadam. Okay, that will purify our body, mind, heart, soul, everything. Yes, Navya, unmute.
Translation. Foods that are too bitter, too sour, salty, hot, or pungent, dry and burning are dear to those in the mode of passion. Such foods cause distress, misery and disease.
Yes. So we saw the food of goodness. These are wholesome food, fatty food, the juicy food. But now coming to the food of passion, these are extremes like too bitter, too sour, too salty. Okay. Hot, pungent. So that means the hot things are more in the mode of passion. Pungent, dry, burning. So these things, these are the food of passion. So definitely these are favorite for the people with mode of passion. Such food, if you take regularly, what will happen? It will increase the distress, misery, disease. So many chronic disease comes because of food of passion. Okay. So this is like very hot foods, chili, spicy, salty. Okay. So everything more in mode of passion. Now unmute Jaimit. Hare Krishna, Jaimit.
Yes, Jaimit, you can unmute. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji.
Yes.
The translation is, food prepared more than 3 hours before being eaten, food that is tasteless, decomposed and putrid, and food consisting of remnants and untouchable things is dear to those in the mode of ignorance.
Yes.
Krishna so, Prasad is transcendental.
Yes. So, food of ignorance is tamasic food, which we should not take. What are those? Food which isn't prepared more than 3 hours. Even food of goodness, when you keep more than 3 hours after preparation, that becomes tamasic. Because if more than 3 hours is over, already decomposition starts. So that's why we should not take those type of food which has been cooked more than 3 hours before. Then food that is tasteless, decomposed, putrid. So that means these are the preserved food. Many preserved foods are very famous today. They will be packaged, preserved and sent in the market. So these are putrid, decomposed. These are very bad for our health. Food consisting of remnants, untouchable things means these are non-vegetarian foods. So non-vegetarian foods, preserved food, packaged food, processed foods, all these are in the mode of ignorance. So those will be very dangerous. This also causes very severe disease. That's why we should always avoid this type of food. So you can see, already these are damaged, but sometimes this thing will be kept in some big hotels. Okay, people will take and eat. So here you can see sattvic food. These are the sattvic food in the mode of goodness. Rajasic, hot food. Tamasic, untouchable.
Prabhuji, can I read this?
But I'll tell you. Then this is, you can see, sattva. See, this person is taking sattvic ahar. So what happened? He will be very peaceful. His body, mind, soul, everything balance. Balance, harmony, positive peace and clarity. Everything is good. Now, this person is rajasic person. He's taking rajasic food. Okay, so what will happen? Movement, activity, energy, excitement. Okay, so he will be always in confusion state. Excitement, anxious, ambitious. These are the rajasic character. Now, coming to tamasic, these people will be very lazy people. Inertia, inactivity, the negative, apathy, dullness. So these are all characters of tamasic people, because it's taking tamasic food. So that's why our food is very important. How food will take, that will reflect in our work, our body, our mind, everything will be changed accordingly. So you can see, this is as per the literature. If you act like something, your next life may be like that. For example, if you take more non-vegetarian, you'll be like tiger. You will be very lazy, means you'll be like bear. And you will take abominable things, means you will be like some pig, okay, swine, like that. It is there. Unmute Navya. Now,
yes,
Navya. Yes, now Krishna will tell about the sacrifice. Navya, please read this. Hare Krishna, Navya, unmute.
Prabhuji, Navya is unmuted already.
Yes, yes, Navya. Hare Krishna. Your voice is not coming. Hare Krishna.
Prabhuji, can you hear me now?
Yes, yes, I can hear you. Please read this.
Yeah. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare.
Before that, translation.
Okay. Translation. Of sacrifices, the sacrifice performed according to the directions of scripture as a matter of duty by those who desire no reward is of the nature of goodness. Yes. Sacrifice in Kali Yuga.
Yeah. So regarding sacrifice, Krishna told to Arjun, what is sacrifice and which type of sacrifice we have to do? So Krishna told us like goodness, passion, ignorance of the food. Similarly, sacrifice also three types. In the mode of goodness, passion and ignorance. Usually the sacrifice in the mode of goodness, usually the person do as a matter of duty. And this is always he follow the scripture. How it is written in the scripture, he will follow very strictly and do this type of sacrifice. And by those who desire no rewards, he do not want any reward for this. It's a duty for him, okay? But next, sacrifice in Kali Yuga. All type of sacrifice are forbidden in Kali Yuga. Previously, what happened? People were doing sacrifice of animal, sacrifice of different vegetable, plant also sometimes they are sacrificing. But today in Kali Yuga, all type of sacrifice are forbidden. Why? Because for sacrifice, you need a pure Brahmin who can chant the mantra and you can purify the animal who are being sacrificed. So that is not possible now. That is the reason all type of sacrifice, killing animal and all in the name of sacrifice are forbidden in Kali Yuga. So only one thing is used in Kali Yuga, that is called Sankirtan Yagna. Yagna means sacrifice. Okay, so only one sacrifice is allowed in Kali Yuga, that is called Sankirtan Yagna. So what is the Sankirtan Yagna? This is. Well, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has spread this Sankirtan Yagna. Chanting, dancing, doing kirtana, Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. So this is the only sacrifice, only yagna allowed in Kali Yuga. All other sacrifices are forbidden in Kali Yuga. Okay?
Hare Krishna Prabhuji.
Yes.
Aditi told that she got disconnected again. Please, can you make a post?
Raise the hand, Aditi. No, again disconnected or what? Yes, Aditi. Yes, sir. Yes. So this is the Sankirtan Yagna, only allowed in Kali Yuga. All other Yagna are all other sacrifices are forbidden in Kali Yuga. Okay.
Yeah, and I'm so sorry, Prabhuji, to get disconnected again and again because.
Okay, no problem.
There's some net problem, that's why.
Okay. So this is our body, mind, and soul, spirit. Everything will be balanced if you will take proper food. So what is the proper food? Proper food is the food of goodness or Krishna Prasad. It is Shuddha pure goodness food, pure food of goodness. Okay. So our body, mind, soul, spirit, everything will be balanced. If we'll take food of passion and ignorance, everything will be disturbed. Now, Sahaj Harji. Please unmute. Read this. This is about the austerities. We heard about the sacrifice. Then what is the austerities and what type of austerities?
Prabhuji, whom shall I unmute?
Sahaj
Hare Krishna Prabhuji.
Yeah, okay, he's unmuted.
Yes, read this.
Austerity of the...
Oh, he's muted. Yeah, I'll unmute him. Sahaj Harji.
Okay. austerity of the body consists in worship of the Supreme Lord, the Brahmanas, the spiritual master, and superiors like the father and mother, and in cleanliness, simplicity, celibacy, and non-violence.
Okay. So, austerity of the body consists of worship of Supreme Lord. Okay. The Brahmana, spiritual master, superior like father, mother. Okay. Then one has to be clean, very simple. Celibacy means it's like brahmachari, and he should not do any violence against anyone. Like it may be human being, it may be any animals. So this is called austerity of the body. It should be very tolerant, very simple. It should be clean. You should respect everyone. Okay, this is called austerity of the body. Next, Rishik Surya.
Yes, Prabhuji.
Read this.
The six Goswami.
Okay, leave it. This is actually the six Goswamis, the six brothers. They are the perfect austerer. Just that. So they were performing the austerities very nicely. The six brothers. Okay, this one read.
Translation. Austerity of speech consists in speaking words that are truthful, pleasing, beneficial, and not agitating to others, and also irregularly reciting Vedic literature. One should not speak in a way to agitate the mind of others, parents, teachers, elders.
Yes, so after austerity of body, this is the austerity of speech. So how we have to speak? So we'll speak in such a mode that it should not hurt anyone. Okay, we should be truthful. Every time we'll tell the truth. Pleasing, beneficial to others, it should not agitate the others. Others should not be getting hurt by your words. That is called austerity of the speech. Okay, so that part we have to take care. Now, who is this person? Can you unmute someone?
Okay, Prabhuji, I'll unmute.
Who is sitting here?
Yeah, there is a Shiver. Please unmute.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji.
Yes.
He is Ram, Prabhuji.
Yes, who is this person?
Prabhuji, I don't know, Prabhuji.
Oh. Yes. This is
Prabhuji, no, sorry. Prabhuji is Ravana's brother.
Yes, Vivisan. So,
Prabhuji, yes? In the end, can you please say the steps of surrender to God, surrenderance to God.
Steps of surrender to God?
Yes, Prabhuji. In the end.
Okay. Okay. So his Vibhishana is Ram. So just after the war is finished, Ravana is killed, then Vibhishan came and he became the king. Now, Vibhishan led to pure life even though he was surrounded by demons. Vibhishan was living in Lankana. There it was full of demons. So still, Vibhishan was very austere and he was staying in a pure life. Now here, he was declared the king of Lanka by Lord Rama because of his austerities. Okay. He was performing the austerities very nicely. That is the reason. After Ravana, he became the king of Lanka. Then Ahan, can you read this?
Excuse me, Prabhuji. Sorry to disturb, but actually even Dhriti, she had some problem. So she got disconnected.
Okay, so I'll do. Unmute Ahan.
Ahan. Okay, I'll unmute.
Yes, read this.
Charity given out of duty without expectation of his return at the proper time and place and to a worthy person is considered to be the mode of goodness.
Yes, so now about the most important thing, that is the charity. Because now and then we are giving charity to many people, maybe beggars, maybe some poor people. But while giving charity, we should be very careful. We should not give charity very lavishly so that it will be problematic for us. So charity is given out of duty without expectation of return at the proper time, proper place, and to a worthy person is considered to be in the mode of goodness. Means you should give to a proper person. If you are not giving to a proper person, a person is healthy, he's asking and you are giving, then it's not the worthy. So it will not be in the mode of goodness. Okay, so you have to be very careful and while giving the charity. Why you have to be careful, I'll tell you. Now you can see here, suppose you have given to a healthy person some food, some money, he utilized that money in wrong way, like he is smoking, taking alcohol. So what will happen? The sin will come to you because this money belongs to you. That is the reason you have to be very careful. So what you have to give, better to give food, clothes and money. So food, if he will not eat, somebody will eat. He won't be do any sinful activities. Clothes also, if he will not wear, somebody else will wear. But money is doubt. Money, yeah, while you are giving, you have to be very careful. Donation box. So what happens when you give money directly to a person, if he does some sinful activities, that sin will come to you. How to nullify that sin? You can directly give to the temple, and through the temple, the charity work is to be done. So by that, you will get the punya karma. Whatever punya you'll get. But if that person do some sinful activity, that won't come to you. Because here God acts as a filter. Okay, that is the reason. Instead of directly giving to the poor people, better to give to the temple, and through the temple it should be distributed. Or through the temple, charity work should be done. Because from the temple, many type of charity work is done, like food distribution, clothes distribution. So it has to be done through the temple. So that is always better, so that you won't get the sin. Kamlesh? Unmute.
Prabhuji.
Hare Krishna. Your voice is not coming. Come less. Hare Krishna.
Kamlesh is not unmuting.
Unmute. Hello. So charity.
Kamlesh is not unable to unmute. Not yes. Unable to unmute.
Okay. Any other person? Navya, unmute.
Navya. Yes, Navya, you can unmute.
But charity performed with the expectation of some return or with a desire for fruitive results or in a grudging mode is said to be charity in the mode of passion.
Yes. So charity of goodness means there is no desire for any return. It's pure. But charity of passion means always you want something from the society. If I'm doing this, people should know me, people should praise me. This type of things should come to mind. See, this person is giving some charity, but he is taking picture. He will keep in the somewhere. He posts somewhere, or he will print in media like newspaper and all. So always there is a grudge. Always there is a desire to become the great. So that is in the mode of passion. Okay. Now, Jaimit, read this.
Hare Krishna Prabhuji. Translation. Any charity performed at an impure place at an improper time to unworthy persons or without proper attention and respect is said to be in the mode of ignorance.
Yes. So now mode of ignorance means you are not giving the charity to a proper person in the proper place. See, this person is having cigarette, taking a cigarette, and I need money for weed. So in this person, suppose you are giving any charity, it is in the mode of ignorance. He will do
Prabhuji?
Yes.
Weed means?
Something like some plant and all.
Okay.
Exactly, we don't know. Something he will write.
And Prabhuji, the kid is giving money to an unworthy person. Yes. Before it, there is a bar and he is smoking.
Yes. So this person is smoking because the kid does not know. He's asking. The kid is thinking that we have to give the charity. He is giving. But before giving charity, you should be very careful whom you are giving, because he will take this money and use for smoking, drinking. So that is a sinful activity. Isn't it? That sin will come to us because this is our money only. So that is the reason if you want to give someone, first you have to see if he is a worthy person. If he is physically fit, is doing sinful activity, never give anything to them. Okay. If you are giving means that sin will come to us. That is in the mode of ignorance. So this is all about the chapter.